Testing. We're on. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Jeff Brenzel, and I teach here at Yale in the Philosophy and Humanities departments. In my role as Master of Timothy Dwight College, I am also the official steward of the Chubb Fellowship at Yale University. So it is on behalf of the Chubb Fellowship, of Timothy Dwight College, of the president and officers and fellows of Yale University, the faculty and staff and students of Yale, and the entire New Haven area community that we welcome His Holiness the 17th Karmapa and his delegation to our community and to our campus. I want to recognize briefly the co-sponsors and the other collaborators who have worked hard to arrange and support the visit of His Holiness and his delegation here to Yale. In addition to the Chubb Fellowship, these are the Yale Himalaya Initiative, the Forum on Religion and Ecology, the Yale Religious Studies Department, the Yale School of Forestry and Environmental Studies, the Yale Divinity School, and the Macmillan Center for International and Area Studies. We are particularly grateful, of course, to His Holiness himself for his generosity of time and spirit in making himself astonishingly available during his time here, putting forth a strenuous effort to meet or speak or connect with so many communities within and without the university who hoped for the opportunity to see and hear him during his stay here at Yale. I want to make special mention of the many members of the Tibetan community from the entire eastern region of the United States who have traveled here to be with us this afternoon, as well as many other Buddhist brothers and sisters from other lands and places. To all of you, I want to extend our warmest welcome. Here this afternoon, His Holiness will be presenting this year's Chubb Fellowship Address. And I should say just a brief word about the fellowship itself. Hendon Chubb was an 1895 graduate of Yale's Sheffield Scientific School, and in 1936, he made a substantial gift to the university with the intent of encouraging Yale students to take a particular interest in public service. Since 1949, as Hendon Chubb himself approved, the university has used his endowment to underwrite a visiting speakers program, bringing extraordinary public figures to the campus. Past Chubb Fellows include four presidents of the United States, presidents of eight other countries, Nobel and other international prize winners, and more than 150 other regional, national, and internationally prominent persons, all of whom have been noteworthy in some particular way for their personal distinction in service to the common good of all. It is now my honor to ask Andrew Quintman to the podium. Professor Quintman teaches at Yale in the Department of Religious Studies, where he specializes in the Buddhist traditions of Tibet and the Himalaya. His work surveys Buddhist literature and history, sacred geography and pilgrimage, and the visual cultures of the wider Himalayan region. He has written several books on the early Tibetan saint, Milarepa, including an English translation of the life of Milarepa, who is a founding figure in the Karmapa's lineage. Well, please welcome Professor Quintman.
Thank you, Jeff. Good afternoon. It is my great pleasure and distinct honor to introduce His Holiness the 17th Karmapa, Orgyen Chinle Dorje, who will share with us today his insight and vision on three crucial topics for our time: compassion, religion, and the environment. In 1949, at the request of Yale's Beinecke Rare Book and Manuscript Library, 100 volumes of the Tibetan Buddhist canon were printed from wood blocks in Lhasa, wrapped in leather satchels and loaded onto ponies. They traveled by caravan to Calcutta and then freighter to New Haven, where they arrived in 1950 and were installed in the library with great ceremony. This gift, presented to Yale by the current Dalai Lama, who was only 14 years old at the time and still living in Lhasa, planted a seed of Yale's connection to Tibet, a seed that has now taken root and blossomed with the visit by His Holiness the Karmapa. The Karmapa is part of a Tibetan tradition of formally recognized reincarnations known as tulku, wherein a young child is identified as the re-embodiment of a deceased master. The Karmapas are the head of the Karmakagyu branch of Tibetan Buddhism and are the oldest such reincarnation lineage in the Himalayan region, extending back some 900 years. His Holiness Orgyen Chinle Dorje is the 17th in his line. The first Karmapa, Dusum Kempa, was born in the early 12th century and is said to have left a letter foretelling the conditions of his future rebirth. Since then, such prediction letters have become a hallmark of the lineage and, together with other religious signs, have been used to identify subsequent Karmapas. The second Karmapa, Karmapakshi, was renowned for his spiritual mastery, which led to his invitation to the court of Kublai Khan. The third Karmapa, Rangchung Dorje, was famous for his exegesis on philosophy and esoteric Buddhist theory. And subsequent Karmapas became consummate religious teachers, great scholars, virtuoso meditators, artists, and poets. They were also teachers who carried out the activities of a Buddha, as the title Karmapa is sometimes etymologized. The 16th Karmapa, Rangchung Rikpe Dorje, fled Tibet in 1959 and established a monastic seat in Sikkim, India. He is remembered for his great love of animals, especially birds, and also for his ability to communicate with them. The 16th was part of an early wave of Tibetan teachers who brought traditional Buddhist teachings to the West. He visited the United States first in 1974 and again in 1977. And during this period, he established a major monastic center outside Woodstock, New York, which now has dozens of affiliated centers around the world. Orgyen Chinle Dorje was born in 1985 in eastern Tibet. And based upon his predecessor's prediction letter and testament, he was recognized and then enthroned as the 17th Karmapa at the traditional monastery of his lineage at Serpu in central Tibet. And I was fortunate to meet His Holiness numerous times at Serpu, and it was clear even then that he was an extraordinary individual. In 1999, he determined that he was no longer able to receive an adequate religious education inside Tibet. And so, over the course of 8 days in late December and early January, he undertook a harrowing journey across the Himalayan range. The story is quite dramatic. It includes a daring escape through an upper story window of the monastery, a trek across frozen mountain passes, and horseback travel through northern Nepal. He eventually reached Dharamsala in India, where he maintains a close relationship with another of Tibet's great religious figures, the 14th Dalai Lama. At 29 years old, His Holiness is already recognized as a leading religious figure of his generation as an accomplished Buddhist teacher. But he is also a prolific artist, poet, and playwright. He is a religious reformer dedicated to gender equality and the restoration of bhikshuni, or full monastic ordination for women. He's a social activist committed to human rights, vegetarianism, and the ethical treatment of animals. He is an environmentalist, focused on the protection of Himalayan landscapes and natural resources through an eco-monastic program called Koryuk, the Tibetan word for environment, that networks more than 50 religious institutions across the Himalaya. In His Holiness's own words, "Whatever it is I do, I want it to have a long-term visible impact and for it to be practical. If I have the opportunity, I would most like to restore the natural environment in the Himalayas and Tibet, and to especially protect the forests, the water, and the wildlife of the region." And I think it is not an exaggeration to say that His Holiness, the 17th Karmapa, will revolutionize Buddhism, not only in the Tibetan tradition, but also on a global scale. The reach of the Karmapa's activities is reflected in the way that his visit has brought people together across Yale University, from the arts and sciences to public health and environmental studies, faculty, graduate students, and undergraduates. Some time ago, long before His Holiness's visit had been publicly announced, one of the 8 Tibetans who works at Yale appeared in my office and enthusiastically said, "I heard the Karmapa is coming." Well, he was. Today's address, entitled "Compassion in Action, Buddhism and the Environment," is the direct result of converging interests, or as Buddhists like to say, of causes and conditions that span the university and its wider community. So the seed first planted some 65 years ago has now begun to flower. So please join me now in welcoming His Holiness, the 17th Karmapa. Do you want to stand next to me or you want to sit? It's just for a minute. So thank you, Your Holiness.
Just for you.
So let me conclude with just a few words about today's program. Following His Holiness's address, he will be joined on stage by myself and my colleague, Mary Evelyn Tucker, for a short conversation about the main themes of the talk: compassion, religion, and the environment. Mary Evelyn is a senior lecturer and research scholar at Yale University, where she teaches in a joint master's degree program between the School of Forestry and Environmental Studies and the Yale Divinity School. And she is also, and perhaps more importantly, the director of the Forum on Religion and Ecology at Yale, together with her husband, John Grimm. The program will conclude with an opportunity for His Holiness to address questions from the audience. Now, over the past week or so, we've collected questions by email from those who would attend today's address, and we have received an enthusiastic response and have selected a representative sample of them. So I would be remiss if I did not acknowledge at least a few individuals who were instrumental in making His Holiness's visit to Yale possible. So my heartfelt thanks go, of course, to the Chubb Fellowship, to Master Jeff Brenzel and Susan Wiggler, to George Joseph of the Macmillan Center for International and Area Studies, and of course to the incredible staff, the indefatigable staff of the Yale Himalaya Initiative, including Program Director Alark Saxena, Anoba Gurung, Priyankar Chand, and Sangye Dorje. So, Your Holiness.
Ta thongwa dilia samwa lo lia ani samji jesi li shuai.
First, I'd like to welcome each and every one of you
Tashidelek means may you be filled with auspicious goodness and joy.
Ane taride yel university lia yonga ki kashre mise de chijang sho sun che de ya yonga chari cheb dang mixe de tirin de kashre da de chari cheb de tu shi shai yin la tarinde yel university yonga ki chari cheb de kashre sho che de sun chari cheb de tu shi shai yin.
And I would also like to thank everyone at Yale University who has been responsible for inviting me and giving me this opportunity to be here.
And honestly, during the science of Samarolia, and Tushishai.
And I would also like to thank all of you who have come here today.
Chidangi Kashwada Amirgalia, you are the little thing Sumber Chadi are. Chesa and a Kaduine Amirgalia, you understand it, Semlia, Kashwada, Mise Dachi, Rangwangi, Sonans and Rado. Danasi digi sona sabar jingi ve sona yondi do and labar do tari university mangbachilia jarche nene kashre jarche susu imnia lubru de tu chi du sane and mangbachi kashre susu imnia lobjong mangbachi tabachi dang danasi kashre dending semlia.
This is my third visit to the United States of America, and whenever I come here, I have a special feeling of freedom and joy, especially this time, the third time, as I've been visiting several universities, I've been overjoyed by the experience of meeting with many students and witnessing a little bit of their study and university life.
That didn't you share the Niji Dam Kuyu Gorb Shadusi? Toshigare.
Now, the topic you've asked me to address is compassion and the environment.
Background of Shivi and Mima watching Alia and the Kura and the Chikashwe, Kuyu Golia, the Tonayong Guard of Chitang and the Tolia and the Chikashwe, Legachegua of Chig, the Yamjong background, the Kares Tinimangusta on the Do, Jesangi Councilia, the Golia, this Shai, the Vichosos.
To give you a little bit of background, many people have asked me, what inspired you to become so concerned about the environment? So I'm going to talk a little bit about that to begin.
Any Kashu Misegi Kashu modern development kind of chem and Kandarji Be Tamology Ranjung Kalia, Jeju Mel, Sosu Mel, Baso Mel, that the Niji neighborhood, the Niji Alia, Nediar, Chesan, Lo Gibbonis, and Lord Jungbado, and the Digi, Chikuru Jinan, Salon Chumadam. And Dana Singi, as a Su Yungi, Dakar Toa Gedan, Ditone, Kurulia, as a Tongsian of Gadachim, Zachimoka Zuyeva, 다나지 쿠유당 미버룩은 제바 미세근 제바 샤당 다디미네 드데지 수수 냠스뇨아 고급 중요비 인두산에 디균센 데네 셈리아 수습 메버서 말베 셈리아 카두이네지 상해를 텐데야 지다 간다 드지 초나 사무지 진여버 지금랑 그 초도
I was born in a quite isolated part of eastern Tibet, and where I was born, there had been no great modern development. So I lived in a very natural and somewhat pristine environment. Until I was seven, this was the only environment in which I lived. So I experienced firsthand as a child a feeling of intimate connection with the natural environment. And I retain to this day a constant and extremely clear recollection of this.
But example to show you, but I'm also pay you a rich, ridden, energy, children, the Mangware, the Mangshe, the Holy Spirit, some of that, the Tachimber, the Sandwich. 나라다 루다 드네 삼루 단지 드네 네데비 이치치기아레 세상 아주 싫아기 다디지 사단 도다 드데긴 두시에 마제비치체 다 living beings 나다도 living system 나지 드네지 비지다 나줄라 베 so 가즈웨 necessary 나다도 so crucial 네르비지 비지 아주 이시르 두시기아레 다나 심페나 아주 룸베 죽주 드네야레 다
For example, where I was born, we regarded and experienced our environment as a living system, a living beings. The mountains, the sources of water, were all regarded as the dwelling places of what I would call holy spirits of various kinds. We therefore respected every aspect of the environment as part of a living system. We didn't wash our clothes or even our hands in flowing water sources. We didn't cast any kind of garbage or any kind of other pollutant into the fire in our hearth. So we regarded the entire environment as innately sacred.
세상 등상 챌린지 가려 어려서나 아주 룸베나 오마지 artificial garbage 섬으로에 진대기 괜히 이길라 수업에서 괜히 매우 인자 아주 딱 괜히 참으로 the use reusable 선에다 딱한테 진대기 정중기 괜히 마더베 artificial 괜히 스케어 말해 세상 등상 artificial 괜히 디소 레이온 두산에 아주 룸베 밀리아 고즈삼발 5만원 신기 런중기 가슈 가비지 난신 다더가 요샤나 안고 가슈에 다지 쿠란 매바 찬도르 선선로 디니지 삼다지 어 디니지 그 토안에 가슈다 엄마 우메게 초알 컴다체도 산 팅상기 artificial thing 가슈에 뭐부터 레인 두산 디즈 가슈에 내당 가지 몇 대가 좀 고쳐
One of the challenges that those who live in such an environment face nowadays is the use of artificial and non-biodegradable substances, because for the first time, they have to deal with real garbage. We didn't really have garbage because we used pretty well everything up, and anything that we did dispose of was easily biodegradable. And now, because of the introduction of artificial materials that are not biodegradable, we have to come up with new ways to dispose of them. And so this, to give you one example, is changing the lifestyle of people in such places.
Chundu philosophy dan diga science da ge ge shin ge ma ne ina di nge lia knowledge ma chung we nge lia emotional so ma ba ta chi sonar de so so dan energy ka ru jang jung ki sonar di nge ne chung di je knowledge je chung ro se zang di jun zen de ne ka da ri ji gam jo ji ye bin du sa ne di jun zen de ne da 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 ji jung jung ku ko le sam dan du sa ne da ji knowledge 직보면 봐. 나대야 선한데 집에 돈에 잘없지. 용도 섭섭 좀 생겼어.
Obviously as a child I had no knowledge of philosophy or science, but I had a strong emotional connection with and a strong feeling for the environment, which means that now that I've begun to acquire a little bit of knowledge, it isn't just knowledge for me, it's based on my strong feelings.
내 삼리야 가슴에다 구류기 다다디 가슴에다 구유 순교 디고리야 아주 상물로 다 너나 지 가슴에 지글 지글 된 삼으로 받아지 아저기 남윤기 아니 미스디 다 쿠유 숨겹디 잡아디 쿠유 당아준 잡아디 하고 쳇블리아 아저기 아니 가슴에 핀준 뛰주 다 핀준 가슴에 띵중 잡아디 하고 가디 계신 분 차디 또 성도
I think that in order to understand the necessity of environmental protection, we need to understand how connected we are to one another and to our environment. So in order to understand our connectedness, I think we need to understand interdependence.
Lots of echo.
Yeah, I'm having a really hard time hearing. I'm sorry.
What do you do?
I don't know. Maybe if I move back.
Really?
Might be better.
Maybe you can sit down.
No? Dietrich said it.
This is
Lasso.
I'm forgot my things also. Okay. The Azugi Save Sedang Sag Kalada and Chia Kuloda. And Tanang Azugi Lundinia, Samolo Kashway, the Ranjungi Kuyulia, Denchi, Sogovichina, and a Ranjungi Kuyula Dene, Negovichadi others.
For example, for us to acquire or eat any food, have clothes to wear, or even to have the bodies we do, all of these things require the interconnectedness of many aspects, of many things and many people within the environment.
Object, the subject. Object, the subject, Chigi, Ranjunku, Deba, G, object, Drochi, Azu, subject, Drochi. The Digi, under boundary, some of it, Adrigi, Kashwe, Tiber, Perulea, Parta, Yavuchi, the Digi, Azu Tongu Arem, says Azu Tindig, Parta, the Gianta, the near Dongwa Chigda, boundary, this Mab Sokadi, Gajimichi Chadibusan. Ting Azu, the Kashwe, Tinjungi Tawatel Dinchi.
The value of understanding interdependence in this regard is that we often feel at some distance from our environment. We divide the world into subject and object, and we feel that the external environment is an object separated from us by some kind of boundary and at some distance from ourselves as subjects. We need to dissolve this artificial boundary and decrease the distance between ourselves and our environment.
Dene indusane nga zuegi randa khuyu gi jeba de ngoma di de nga zu xie do tuya ji dang nga zu de khuyu gi jeba de ta ni er dong dong ya lia dong tu de sang do stine che bina.
And I think if we do that, we can begin to feel how connected we are to our environment, and how little distance, if any, there really is between ourselves and our environment.
Sustaining some way, hold as some of the hold in the Chedevichita and Nank Simjin Tamje, Simjin Digidi, any Chiku Dilla, then nutrients, some of the Chedevich, Chedevich. That leads us on Digun Zil Dena Tigi, Nerd and Chigi, Casual Pension of Digi. Azu the Kuyu Jabadi and Samu in Devichitang, energy necessary in Devichi, that did turn to what assumption is.
In Tibetan, we often refer to the relationship between the external environment and the beings who inhabit that environment as the relationship between a container and its contents. We are all held by and within the environment we inhabit. We are like the contents or even the nutrients within such an environment. And it seems that it's necessary for us to begin to acknowledge that interrelationship.
Penuki Penuki Shugan Tayar Langazu Yan Kuulia and Shugan Shati Artist. Mima was in Samuel Nalolia, Kuu said the natural said be Yachambuimba, Shuchambuimba. The name is Sane and a Nazuki natural Shugan Tato Marasam Duchi. The reaching yard the Embina, the reality, we need to tell you at the member. Nazu in a Pashugan Tayare and Kuuzu in a Shugan Tayabti as to sing artists.
We therefore also need to acknowledge the fact that our environment can affect us, and we can also affect our environment. Some people have the idea that the environment is so vast and so primordial that nothing we do is actually going to affect it. Unfortunately, that's been proven not to be the case. And we need to begin to acknowledge the interdependence that the aspect of interdependence that is our effect on the environment, even as our environment affects us.
Knowledge understand you the deep in your mind. Kadu ine ngazul kyenji garcha ge arsana understanding their energy presence samarwe ta ngaranzu chue da kasa se wona shin understanding the person di parulaya phanda chim parta chim bu ye de bichi understand the jikcha person gi khurang gi nam yung gi lega le da da sam da da de understanding de shi da ma thi mu de bichi adri ni bisane di junsel de ne Azugi, that understanding seven nursing, and Kasa digi reaction, good behavior there, ten and Shinji Omber Chevalia Azulia, that emotional levels and a down from heart, some of the Ning Tabane, Azulia, the Kuyulia, Sungurudan, Ninji de Gua, the catchment.
Well, we need to acknowledge these things. Mere knowledge or understanding alone, of course, is not enough. One of our problems is that we tend to separate ourselves as persons from our knowledge or understanding. And if we understand or know about the need for environmental protection but do not apply it in our daily lives, we're not going to achieve anything. Our knowledge, our understanding has to become so intimate, so personal to us, that it naturally changes our behavior, that we feel it emotionally and in our hearts.
Didu dan jaba yebaji tone ngodu cha tang ti tholya samdwa di kechum shu cha di du samdwa.
We need therefore to reflect upon the fact that our knowledge of the environment really is a knowledge of something that's going to affect our lives, a knowledge of something that is going to affect our well-being.
Energy, cultural, spiritual traditions, and around religious tradition, the Zugi culture, the Shemshu Drutuya, and Shemdi Drutuya, one would culture Shemdi Drutuyachi, younger Sambed, Ishayus.
And I think it is in that regard that spiritual and religious traditions can serve the cause of environmental stewardship.
The Nidusana, that is not what you woman. That's environmental protection that the root of my imba. Tingy zama, Garzu Siri zama imba. The condition is Susugi Garzu Mizina Lolia Susugi, the Tonanda Jevda, Ning Tabana, the Mizina Lola, La Lente Dalia, Dendendi Garzu Azula, Gia, the Gioma Chevala, Romchet or something.
And when I say religious traditions, I don't just mean Buddhist traditions. I mean every religious tradition in this world can play its part. And I'm confident that if we do this, if we work together, if we apply the knowledge that is embodied in the many indigenous cultures that have survived, the ancient wisdom of our ancestors, we will be able to discover together that environmental protection is not just a point of view, not just a science, but must be a way of life.
Samsam Uma David Nizutralia, Azuji Sindi Badang, Chulu Sidusane, Takunin Kasuda, Gawan Ganda Dovich. The Nindusan, the Jigi, Samsam Jigiana Tan. chik chana tsam tsam yang enemy nabu chik chulu bu tizu science gaba gyab, scientist tizu chulu gaba gyab tinga subchi, chik zin gaba gyara chinga subchi. Ta yinbi na yaa, ngu yu nizu tuwa la yinbi na, ta nga zu chik tsam tsam, chik tumung ka tuwa na, nga zu ki dro mi dang, an dana shing ki, maung zambu ling ki, maung bi che do, tumung ka tuwa na, nyam zi shishi dhru tuya dhri, yong si ka yawar, bena, kuyuk nedan dhile tuwa la chewa yinbi na, Dendeng da tuyumung tuwaane nga zuyuk shibshu dhukwaa di kandri dhuwaa di samdungwaa di kechimbre karayasana kuyuk nedyun di beyond samarwe religion, beyond the political dhuzi chagyebi indyusan nga zuyuk samye nyamdo chawa dhukwaa di kechimbi imbachi rannam gitongyus.
At various times in our history, science and religion have seemed to be contradictory to one another. Have even become enemies, attacked one another, or to be more polite, refuted one another. But really, there is a great commonality of experience that we all share. We're all human beings living in the same world, relying on the same environment. And therefore, on that basis, on the basis of acknowledging our shared or common experience, we have to accept that the protection of this environment is beyond the views of any one religion.
responsibility nyamdo lega le kwa di ta kechum shivchi ta di labar du kuyug nedyun di nga zu za chagu shivcha di ga re je zang nga zu ta scientist mangbu chi gi nga zu kashwe information mangbu chi gi ga re ta yine mangbu chi liya information mangbu chi liya ane di dagbu gyam la len ta ye ta nye mewe kan ta du ta gaba gyang ye di re mangbu yong di ga du pina climate scientist this one gaba yang de de du san di jun zaten na ma jun ge nyam do kuwa de ke chmi isra sam da
if we base our approach to environmental stewardship on being loving and compassionate there should be no contradiction between science and spirituality we can share undertake and share our common responsibility for this environment. And in that way, actually put into practice and make practical use of the information that scientists give us about the environment and not live as though we are in denial of it.
Jisa di kuyo li sungkyub chaya kola ya tang di tola ya ji kashwe koto beya chedu nga zu di tomar ji Himalaya tang rigyu liye be gwendi tisu liya nga zu lopsu chay chay an ko zu kuyo di kachim imi kuyo kola ya koto be an dini gyu chay ene ji kashwe community liya shugen tetu ya aju bezur chigyares
the Himalaya including the Tibetan and the Tibetan plateau are considered a treasury of water that feed the great rivers of Asia and therefore supply so much water that sometimes the Himalaya is called a third pole. Therefore, we have to be especially concerned with the environment in the Himalaya and the conservation of water there. So what we have tried to do is train monasteries in best Himalayan monasteries in best environmental practices so that they can then present these to their local or neighboring communities.
Very emotional.
When this subject was first introduced to representatives of these monasteries, they were immediately emotionally affected and demonstrated tremendous commitment to environmental stewardship in their region. But at the same time, we lack a scientific knowledge and technical expertise. So in order to do this, we need the support of the scientific community and the assistance of the scientific community. And I mention this as an example of how, in order to preserve our environment, we all need to work together and offer our individual skills and knowledge. I'm going to end my initial address or talk with that, and we'll begin the conversation. Before we do, however, I again want to thank each and every one of you for coming here and convey to you my sincere delight in having this opportunity.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Can you hand me a glass of water?
Thank you, Your Holiness, and thank you, translator.
Yeah.
We wanted to begin by picking up on a point that you've made earlier.
Yes.
About the root of compassion is having a steadfast heart, the power of the heart. And this work with the environment for many people can be discouraging because it's so overwhelming mm-hmm. right now. Mm-hmm. So could you speak about this need for a steadfast heart, the power of the heart mm-hmm. in compassion?
Mm-hmm. Oh, power. Daddy, activist.
Well, first of all, I would say that many activists, and especially environmental activists, naturally become highly emotionally invested in their activism. And when after years and years of very hard work, they don't see a great deal of result, they can become a little bit embittered and angry.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And if you spend enough time listening to one dire prediction about the future of this planet after another from environmental scientists, even we listeners can develop a little bit of a problem in our brains.
Yeah.
I think there are two levels or types of activism, and the one is what we all practice. We can practice it by being supportive of intensive activism, but even if we are in denial of the need for environmental activism, because we're having an effect on the environment, you can call it a type of mere activism.
The
other type of activist is what we would normally refer to as a non-environmental activist, and that's someone who intentionally undertakes responsibility and puts great effort into the achievement of, in this case, environmental goals and changes. I think that one thing that's very important is for those of us who are less directly involved to take some responsibility and be supportive as much as we can of environmental activism, because if you look at the situation, there is absolutely no reason not to support environmental activism.
To use myself as an example, I'm a vegetarian. And becoming vegetarian, which in my case is partly for environmental reasons, is something that anyone can do. It doesn't require an organization, it doesn't require the extensive scientific knowledge or anything like that. But nevertheless, as simple as it is, when you do that, when you make that kind of change in your life, it's very encouraging because you realize that you're not without power. You have the ability, even as one person, to do at least something that is beneficial to the environment. I think that the greatest source of courage for us in environmental stewardship comes from making such simple changes in our lives and realizing how much power we do have.
Mm. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, so Your Holiness, just to follow up on that last point, you raised the question in The Heart is Noble, where you said, what does it take for our ideas to move our heart? So that is, what is it that moves us to overcome our habits and desires like meat eating or mass consumerism? So I wonder if you could say a little bit about what it means to move past good intentions and move into actual action.
Lots of echo, actually.
Samba, zombo, the
the nyecha ne tomba gi depke na na sombare
samba
zambo sam ji dega mare ngus la len go go dos
aso
pena te sha pawwa da go da mass consumerism pawwa la so pa de de samba zambo sam da la len gi ba ta ke ke drawa drawa kare yo te samba da go kare yo
also consumerism we talking about
yes sure
oh yeah samba samba zo ni komi ji la len
la len tayak samba samba yana la len ta go with this la len tayak you mean how to bridge
yeah.
good intentions yeah. into the samba samba dong ngus la len ta wa ke ba ta ke samba da wa ka
bridge
under your
ta ha ja bridge ta deli ya tatien jeba yeme ka chi chi len chi kem jeba actually you can repeat that again
sure
I'm sorry
your holiness you mentioned yourself you've written before and in talks that you've given that when you were quite young you were
yeah.
fond of eating meat
Mm-hmm.
But you had the good intention of giving that up. You now
yeah.
are vegetarian.
Yes.
And that is taking a good intention and putting it into
Still
action.
Still, I like meat, but it's okay.
But many people wonder how to take a good intention and to actually
okay.
put it into practice.
Okay. Put it into practice. Daddy. Yabu mevji haku gare ine yabu mev haku ge ge la tando sa dio
well to use the example you brought up my vegetarianism as you mentioned as a child I ate meat in fact I only stopped eating meat about 8 years ago so I kept on eating meat for many years but I knew it was wrong I still ate it
then you understand it Ninji sene rado ta kanda ning dob telia kashure ning ge dob se du san ta kanda telia ji shung ro ji su su par gwa ta ge chim ro shu ji kar ju su su tang do lang ne gen ro ji kur ji ma ju dang gen kur ne ta ji ya gen kur wa da an da na xin gi tam ji wa sa ma ra tam ji wa ta ji de ni ji gwa da ta ge chim cha de ma ra som cheng do tam ji dang gen kur ro di and so so gi so 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 le yang gen bi ku so 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 le ya tam ja wa bi che che and so so gi ta ga ru lang ga di se bo so ga di ma zu le ya leng ge yo ra sam chen yu
in that type of case I think that the bridge is a type of compassion a type of courage the power of your heart and By the power of your heart, I mean that which enables us to decide once and for all to take responsibility for our own actions as individuals, to be able to commit ourselves to accepting and fulfilling our responsibilities as a person.
Mm-hmm. that take action to check out the that get you should chat you are nam ju nga zhe gi seng na lo le ya zhe mang bu advisor mang bu jing yong de de ne chen ya bu de ne chen ka le ne sam in ji mi ji da su su take action to check out the de du xin si sam tang
so the bridge is that a mere understanding become a more emotionally felt and a deep emotional feeling based on understanding will inspire us to take action once we listen to the advice of our hearts
thank you
You spoke on science and religion, a very important topic, a very complex topic. I'd love you to speak a little bit more, because for many years, scientists have been speaking about climate change and the environment. And now, there's a new moment when some scientists are saying, this is no longer an issue of science alone, but a moral issue. And that's what your work encourages us in this new dialogue of science and religion. Can you speak on that?
Wow. Ajudi kashmida ta kong sumne sine kuyug ne den de banglang ge ne den cha den do somos the moral issue lagba do ajugi kuyul ne dan de crucial ne dan yong goe chigi de garasan ajugi human greed somro da ji drami gi an dengam la den chongde bchi dengam de ajugi da ji media da tizu to ane increase chi ge de advertise increase chi ga de tela de ne nga ju sang lo do ga shwe ji ga shwe da e yin bi ne nga ju gi dengam la ta yo ma ne de ba zon de ma ne ina jung jung khu ru gi resource de le ya zon de ya re de ni lu sa de jun zen de ne nga ju nge ba du su su aju gen khu ru dengam de ne gen khu ji control cha wa de ge chu bi da re ina ya da di ga shwe ji da de to lo ngwe ni ju to le ya Then Galahab Shore. Jazz under the church or torn, loves a chequat. Near some of the church loves a sadi personal practitioner, person Gersosulia, the Pento Yabas and the Masabi, church or torn, Benaji global issues, the Marie, Benaji Kuyu Nedu in a gender issue, the Zutoli Mina, church or torn, then dengue, Gartreji, T Toli Mina, Chug Tornama, Gartreji. Langdorki, langga sebuj tenggu hati, kecium sibre sam tenggius. Sam sam tinga zuki, cuk, uti de di zutuan, sam sam takda di cetu amanas. Di sam sam azu, di ze feeling, azu di zong ngosabre rongdos. Ta kandar yang, ta da di kuyuk nedun di, di da di cik karsure, cik nedun sama imba. That Nanki draw me simgi, Nedun Chadi, did a devashi, she said the tell Chadi or something to us. The Chadi you in Dusan, then dig a gun then you are machine parto? And eh, Kuulia, you are don't say the Kalahoshi. Kuulia, Sancho and Joya said the Kalahoshi, Chadi or something to Lin Dijun Zenden and Delia and Church or Tony and Chicago. Based on scientist knowledge, that garbage information, the key in the motivation,
As you said, environmental protection or conservation is fundamentally a moral issue. And the reason, the crucial factor in it that makes it a moral issue is that the degradation or destruction of the environment has been caused by human greed. And our human greed, bad enough as it is to start with, has only been exacerbated, fed by our media and our advertising industry. The problem we face, therefore, is that human desire is limitless, but environmental resources are limited. And therefore, it is our responsibility as those who depend on these resources to rein in and control our greed. In order that we start doing so, it is essential that religious leaders, spiritual teachers, not only preach about individual practice issues or individual moral codes, but also about global issues, and that they provide moral guidance on environmental stewardship, because they are the ones who can evoke feeling, evoke enthusiasm, evoke an emotional commitment in their followers. Until we accept the fact that our environment is not external to us, it pervades us, it's within our bodies and our minds as well, it will be difficult for us to change our behavior. But the key to becoming really motivated to change the way we live and thereby begin to heal the environment, the key that will open the door to that type of motivation seems to be in the hands of those religious and spiritual leaders who are willing to provide moral guidance concerning the environment that is based on sound scientific knowledge.
Thank you. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. So to take the conversation in a slightly different direction, Your Holiness, you spoke about the practice of dissolving the distinction between subject and object, the inner and outer worlds. And of course, there are many techniques for putting that into practice in meditation. You can study about that, you can practice it. But I wonder, does the practice of cultivating, of dissolving that distinction, naturally lead to a feeling of connection for the environment, for an appreciation of the environment?
No. Appreciation.
当我最能用让的闲下的 practice 忙不起样的样的当心念别个meditation团的当心念别个的就俺上路去地图个错也不几个研究啥呢 俺们地图作业本来是没想到地图作业有印度啥，俺是上面记不来上大学，听那个到了meditation下，那第一个就告诉俺自己，当心两百的，拉链个脱了，两链个脱了，家就那句话的话嘞，当然那些俺说当心，千万是都啥呢？但得来讲就菜脱了不切切，俺那人呢，别这个大的闲事啊，就扩散，他得都没办法去切。 人家打的个吃些的不讲，打的，咸的吃些不咸的不吃，那咸的让你都吃，都吃。人家这吃，他吃不到呢，那第一个地图的呀，从哪里呀？所以说个这个火化这里什么的，100%的这个，搞着错都不吃啊，这样的要的。他讲那新的，天天念不着去，俺自己苦又到了一边呀。
We have a number of meditation practices, as you mentioned in your question, concerned with dissolving, the false boundary between self and other. One of these is contemplating the equality of oneself and others, which is fundamentally developing an empathetic recognition that just as I want to be happy and not suffer, so do others, and that in that we're exactly the same. And once you have taken this to heart, then of course you have to put it into practice and live accordingly. We also do meditations on exchanging oneself for others, where you actually imagine yourself in the position of another and that other in the position of yourself. And you try to imagine as wholeheartedly, as 100% as possible, how they feel, what they're going through, and then apply that. So there should be ways to extrapolate from these techniques and apply them to environmental awareness. Mm-hmm.
本来我就行动的，就上单位的自行拿出来的是，我就给 oxygen， 可是单位 oxygen 的药物。 ngachi pa tangbe gi ji carbon dioxide ga da da di kuzu pa ngu dini chi gor ba ngachi kuzu ta da ngachi ngu ngachi ta da kuzu ngu dini chi du san da di ji ngachi nem gi tong len gi cha di ane ji sam tong mu ba ren xin de yue de be so shi de ge tuo ne gan da ngachi ji wu gi gua chi bo yin de bi chi wu lam ji de de bi chi 우기 교화 집어 있는데 그렇지 가서 다 간다지 우 당사를 찍 있는데 그렇지 근데 지금 토리아 아니 지금 메디테이션 세비 있는 땡땡 아주 선한데 지 간다 미신도 찍 나를 근데 우기 교화 집어 교회 랑가를 찍고 있는 내지 삼 동안 찍기 삼 정도
For example, if we think about the fact that trees, so to speak, breathe out. Well, we need to breathe in oxygen, and we breathe out carbon dioxide, which they seem to need to, so to speak, breathe in, so that our exhaust is their air, and their exhaust is our air. This is something we don't need to imagine. This is a fact. So if you contemplate that, just the interrelationship or interconnectedness of breathing, of our breathing and the vegetation, things that grow, that could be a meditation technique in and of itself. Because if you feel that, you realize that we're really two parts of one whole machine or one whole system.
We wanted to give a chance for a few questions from the audience which were submitted in advance.
Yes.
So maybe two,
two.
Out of some very
Thank
good
you.
Questions.
Thank you.
The first one is on climate change.
Mm-hmm.
Climate change, or global warming, appears to be the world's greatest crisis.
Mm-hmm.
But there are many people who deny global warming exists. What advice would you give to working with people in the government who believe there is no need to protect the environment?
Oh, I don't have all the solutions. I think this is,
You don't have to answer it either.
Yeah. This, that area, the classroom, 초진이 구유기 균도가 사드 남식이 균도 클라이밋 체인지 사드 야체 뭐 쉬우지 야체 다 취해네 딘 균도 어디 가서 다 고쳐 디 초르도 가면 야체 다 취해 초르 초르면도 다 이내 니마 저 초와 준비 걸라 직진은 출래야 차대야 드려지 데인주산 디 균제 되네 드나에 챙게 되서 직보 말해 지당 그 미규마 되서 디 고조 디 climate change yara sana de hira karshwe pena thing sa phel ya dengen de zul khabar dan ju sa karshwe de phel namshi thamu yorwa je sa kudu nima tra ka ba yor ste trail ka ba yor thamu yezo ta thing sa khade do la thing sa ya bo do namshi charu chin ya bo do su kudu di charu chin ba du bu ji thong ga ma ta ya bo do den de ji yong de yare de ne ya di gi de le ya dang gi gong de shu ba ne sing gi Taji politician da mabu chik deny chigara di imine taki kondi shubana isi nga chuki ene chocho the religious leader tizul la jeba chichi dindi chik tuwa ne tizul ki dupshu la dene nga chuki faith in karchwe chiki devotion ni sambar ta dindi ki dupshu la dene chik nga chuki di karchwe dende nga nga chuki climate change da andana shingi kuyu ki nedun tizu
Well, the climate change is a huge process.
Mm-hmm.
It's very vast. It has all kinds of sub bits and pieces. And it's a somewhat gradual process so that we don't directly feel it. Or notice it day by day. By the time that we all feel climate change, it will be far too late to do anything about it. So there really are two levels of denial here. There's the denial of those who are actual climate change deniers, politicians and others, and then there's the denial that most of us live in of climate change, where because we don't actually feel it, it's not really in our minds most of the time. And then there are little pockets of odd reactions. For example, Tibet is a very cold country. It's often hard to get warm enough. And so the global warming, some Tibetans have greeted this with enthusiasm, saying it doesn't get as cold as it used to. It's much more pleasant. As for what to do about politicians and others who are active or outspoken climate change deniers, the best thing might be to appeal to support from religious and spiritual leaders, because they have so much influence over their respective communities or devotees.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, Your Holiness, the last question is one a number of our undergraduate students asked. And that is, how can students in a university like Yale organize themselves to take fruitful and positive action for the environment? What can they do that's practical?
Environment demonstration thana singi di tholya benaji kachureda ji misegi take action cha mangbu chu andi are ta ine kechi shu di tambu susu ning go zuwa de kechi shu to su kar su susu gi ji guan ru ta ji chebi mina te den den ji susu ji chebi ni san te la den shi ne ene susu le ji ning du chenbu ji ge ya ji shi za ya gu shi chu chung le su te me bi che ji Susuni, Missin, Duas Katam, Munuchi, and Mission that Chigiri is some digital reward of the expectation which Chevina, that digs Samsung Azuliadi, Jig Susu, Jig Katu, Jawam, Jawas Sandra, Tendigi, Jigarre, Jawas Sevitona, Mijimbing Ebayoman, Stream D, Use, then Susun and Gozuadi, that's if Jigashim. Ansonglo. Misdirection to Chigilia, Susung and Dua, Rikalahan's bounce, the name Gotsuchi, Kanda, Kuyugi, Gartridge, protection, the name Gotsuchi Chadi, that catch him ship or something at all. Tanaji, Susugi, aspiration D, and so mission that Susu the Melam Chibuyeva, Tisu the Nyamdo Ruchechi, and so aspiration D, lonely in the which is somewhere. Kerjan, which may be Chichi, aspiration D, that.
Of course, there are several things we can do as groups or communities. The usual types of environmental activism, demonstrations, raising our voice, and so on. But fundamentally, each of us has to start with ourselves. Because the only solid basis for the type of courage it's going to take to actually make these changes comes when you have made changes in your own life and have begun to feel the effects of that. And that courage can't be taken away from you, so you won't lose it in the process of a long career of activism. Otherwise, if we attempt to change or convince others to change without having changed the way we live our lives ourselves, we will be fueling ourselves, not with an internal courage, but with expectations. And when others don't change the way we would like them to, we'll become disillusioned and possibly totally burnt out altogether. So we have to start. Whatever we may do on a social or communal level, we have to start by making individual changes in our own lives. Mm-hmm. And then another thing that is necessary is to have a support community, mm-hmm. a supportive community of those who share one's own environmental aspirations and ideals.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
We'd like to conclude by thanking His Holiness for reigniting hope this evening. And I'd like to say it was 20 years ago that we began a project at Harvard, actually, with one of the first conferences on Buddhism and ecology.
Yes.
And then the other world religions yes. and ecology.
Yes.
But it is our great joy that Yale has picked up this idea that religions and ecology can work together, which you have highlighted today. And our School of Forestry and Environmental Studies, with the students there and students from religious studies and divinity, I think are giving us hope because they understand this. They want to work with your communities, and we want to figure ways into the future. I want to end, though, with a special thanks to our dean, Peter Crane, who has held up this effort between the School of Forestry, Environmental Studies, and Divinity. And tomorrow night, we're going to continue the conversation with Peter Crane, scientists, ethicists, and so on, between these two schools to examine the new papal encyclical, which will be coming out this summer, exactly on this issue, which can affect 1 billion Catholics, 2 billion Christians, but be in dialogue with the efforts that you're doing. So tomorrow night at Lindsay Hall on High Street at 5:30, we invite you to join in this discussion that will complement the wonderful words that you have given us tonight. Thank you for your hope, and please come back to Yale
yes,
to visit us.
Please do come
Thank
back.
You.
Thank you. Thank you. It was wonderful.
Thank you.
La sola.